My talk today is titled Algorithms of Rage to Rhythms of Change, Notes on a Research and Life's Journey. It was a wintry Sunday afternoon in Ottawa. I was sipping a cup of coffee while scrolling on the laptop screen. What? Did my tweet just get viral? How did it happen? I had viral moments before, but this was my first tweet about Canada. 2 days prior, I tweeted a graphic of Freedom Convoy networks, but didn't check my Twitter again until Sunday. I rarely tweet and only have a handful of Canadian followers. I didn't expect that this graph would gain attention at all. All the comments came from strangers. Most were very supportive. Not only people love my graph, they also fill me in with info to further my research. And oh, some posted me this meme. They think I'm like that. But of course, the tweet also invited those who not only disagreed with my data, but also were very angry. Very quickly, spams and angry messages arrived in my mailbox. Someone even classified me as Canadian New Age fascist, namely today's modern fascists who simply hate on other Canadians. This was my first experience dealing with the Canadian rage. I mean, Canadians people rage. Of course, long before that, since I came to Canada, I have been subjected to the ongoing rage of the Canadian geese, aka Cobra Chicken. My story dealing with algorithmic rage is not extraordinary. Our tales of life are deeply entwined with digital media, where not only our activities are intermediated by algorithmic media, but our feelings too are entangled with algorithms. More than a decade ago, Silicon Valley made algorithms came with a promise to bring reliability and objectivity to otherwise uncertain procedure. Since then, however, most of us have fine-tuned our expectation. We have come to the terms that algorithms are not neutral. They can be deeply imbued with subjective interests, the interests of powerful and even greedy players, and unconscious biases of their creators and designers. Originated from the name of the creator of the first algorithm, Muhammad ibn Musa al-Khwarizmi, a 9th century Persian mathematician and astronomer, algorithm can be defined as a set of definite steps structured to process instruction or data to produce an output. But these days, when we talk about algorithm, we mainly refer to computer program algorithm. Social media algorithms, to be specific. What do social media algorithms look like? There are many different algorithms utilized by social media platforms, and they keep on changing. However, in a nutshell, the social media algorithms underpinning concept is machine learning, where an algorithm uses historical data from users' past behaviors to predict and influence their future behaviors. Social media algorithm primarily are not designed to provide quality experience for users. Rather, they are meant to maximize user engagement, defined as likes, reaction, comments, share, and click-throughs, to better target user or brand advertising. Over the years, social media algorithms have evolved not only to cater the economic of attention, but also the economic of emotions, where emotions are leveraged to generate attention and viewing time, which converts to advertising revenue. So algorithmic biases privilege content that evoke emotion. A recent expose from a Facebook whistleblower reveals that the platform ranking algorithm treated emoji reaction like love, haha, whoa, sad, and angry as 5 times more valuable than generic likes. Simplified and sensationalized content with superlative values, the most sensational, the most controversial, the cutest, the funniest, the racist, measured quantitatively by the number of reaction it throws, therefore tend to be more visible than mundane, moderate, comprehensive, informative, and complex contents. Algorithmic dynamic allows us to meet people with similar interests, similar hobbies, and possibly similar pursuits. However, due to its tendency to amplify the extreme, it can perpetuate the formation of what I term algorithmic enclave. This is a discursive arena that is formed when individuals, facilitated by their constant interaction with algorithms and with each other, collectivize based on a perceived shared identity online for defending their beliefs and protecting their resources from both real and perceived threat, usually from a common enemy. Within these enclaves, many regressive communities thrive, including the far right. Capitalizing on emotion-driven algorithmic biases, the far right, such as the Freedom Convoy, has been successful in propagating the binary populist framework, we the people versus the corrupt and evil elites, to foster an inside rage among discontent citizens. With a little help from algorithms of rage, human users exercise their freedoms to hate.